Our featured artist today is the very talented Jen Lewin. You know Jen from many times she's played at Jazz Vespers before. Wonderful piano player, amazing vocalist. You just heard her play piano in the introduction. I can't wait for you to hear her singing and what else she's going to do today. Our second reason is today is Reverend Gary Paterson's final Jazz Vespers as a minister on staff at St. Andrews-Wesley. Fortunately, rumor has it that Gary will still be around and happy to drop in to lead a service from time to time when he's in town, and his partner Tim hasn't swept him away to some wonderful part of the world. Gary has been in ministry for 44 years, if you can believe it, and has been at St. Andrews-Wesley for 16 years, including the 3 years he served as moderator for the United Church. I have to say, Gary, from the Musicians of Vancouver, a couple of things I'd really like to thank you for. When you came here to St. Andrews-Wesley, you took over Jazz Vespers from Gordon Turner, and you didn't let it slip an inch. You kept it going strong through all these years. I joined a few years after that, and we've been working together, and I have really enjoyed working with you. And all the musicians in Vancouver call me and say, I had a great time, loved what the ministers had to say, and much of that is from your history with this service. So thank you for all your years of service, and I really do want to see you again several times, a year, whatever. Over the years, we've all benefited from your sharp mind, your good heart, your care for the world and love of the way jazz provides insight into faith and life and the life of faith. Today, Reverend Dan will lob the questions to Gary, who will offer his own reflection. But let's begin with our opening note. Let's get away from it all. Take it away, Jim.
Let's take a boat to Bermuda. Let's take a plane to St. Paul. Let's take a kayak to Quincy or Nyack. Let's get away from it all. Let's take a trip in a trailer. No need to come back at all. Let's take a powder to Boston for chowder. Let's get away from it all. Travel round from town to town. We'll visit every state, Alaska and Hawaii too. Then on the 48, let's go again to Niagara. This time we'll look at the fall. Let's leave our hut, dear. Get out of our rut, dear. Let's get away from it all.
Thank you so much, Jen. That's fabulous. We always appreciate your musical contributions when you're able to be with us. And we're grateful that you all were able to tune in today for this Gary Paterson's final Jazz Vespers service while on staff at St. Andrews-Wesley. The good news is that the congregation has unanimously selected Gary to join Tom Miles as our minister emeritus of the congregation. And that means that fortunately for us, Gary's still going to be around. He'll still be involved in the life of the congregation. He'll still be offering sermons from time to time and jazz vespers services from time to time when you're available. The difference is that Gary can just say, nope, sorry, we're going to be in Bali that week or whatever, right?
Yes, if only.
He'll have freedom.
Yes.
But fortunately, Gary will still be connected with our community. So hopefully this won't be the last time that you ever hear from him. But it is a significant transition time. And so, Gary, I just wonder if what that song conjures up for you as you think about your more fulsome retirement. Is there a part of you that just wants to get away from it all and looks forward to just taking off?
Well, it's strange you should ask, Dan, because the end of June is full of excitement about the possibilities that might emerge, and also with some anxiety, because I've been here for 16 years, and like Jazz Vespers has been such a gift, a whole new form of service for me. My brother's a jazz musician, and so he introduced me to some of the musicians, the music, the rhythms, the history, and then all of a sudden I've had this opportunity of being able to watch the intertwining of jazz and the spirit, our little tag phrase of jazz and spirit dance together at these vespers, a way of trying to reflect on music and then to see the depths of possibility and of faith that emerge from that. Mm-hmm. I mean, jazz feels to me almost like a quintessential spiritual music. I mean, we have the greats like John Coltrane of Love Supreme or Duke Ellington with his sacred concerts and other names I could mention, but I discover often in jazz itself there's always a way of going deeper. And I so appreciate that gift in jazz, which I think is in its roots from Afro-American conditions of slavery and suffering and the whole gospel and the blues. And so I'm looking at my retirement. Yeah, I want to just get away from it all. And I have a spouse who is planning a travel around the world when finally the pandemic restrictions raise. But I also know that for me it's an opportunity to do something deeper. And I'm not sure what that is. I feel like I'm trying to keep myself open to the call.
Right.
I am convinced that the Spirit will move and say, there is more than just kicking back.
And I wonder if you knew exactly what it was that was going to take you deeper, it wouldn't be connected to jazz. Because part of jazz is having that open-ended attitude to whatever comes next. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't know, you can't plan it.
Yeah.
You don't know what your partner's going to be playing in that improvised solo. Yeah. There is that attention to whatever is next.
That's right? Absolutely true. And I think with the song that Jen just offered and shared with us, you almost find that compilation of kickback, and yet underneath there's something deeper. Mm-hmm. This is a song to celebrate. Like, let's just take it easy, either in retirement or post-pandemic. Yeah. But then you also say, this is so classically blues music, where you can refer to the pain and yet sing with some joy and some laughter. I mean, it connects back to jazz funerals. I mean, here we are, we're going to have the marching band at one of the saddest moments, and yet even in that kind of pain and grief and suffering, there is the presence. So I had the sense in hearing that song, oh, I'm going to be running away. I'm going to do all those exciting things. On the other hand, I feel like there's this call to do and be something deeper, which I think is what we've always striven for in Jazz Vespers. Mm-hmm. So one of my favorite passages of Scripture comes from the prophet Habakkuk. You miss him usually. He's only about three or four chapters right near the end, and so very few people know about him. But he's struggling with really horrible times for the people of Israel. And he says, you know, when the fig tree does not bloom and there is no fruit on the vine, and when the yield and the produce of the olive fails and there is no food in the fields, and when the flock are cut off from the fold and there are no cattle in the stalls, yet still, nevertheless, despite all of that, I will still praise the Holy One and find in God my strength and my salvation. And I think in the midst of these pandemic times, or all the things and challenges that life will send to us, there is, in both faith and in blues, that sense that nevertheless, that magical word, be honest, be truthful, say what is, acknowledge that we want out of this. Oh my God, do we? And yet at the same time, we're ready to put our shoulder to the wheel and go deeper and wait and trust in something that we name, well, differently, so many different names for God, but that holy presence, that mystery that will call us, inspire us, and give us strength.
It reminds me of that beautiful phrase that I first heard from Bob Smith. Maybe it goes beyond Bob, I'm not sure. But that attitude of alleluia anyway.
Yeah.
In spite of it all,
yeah.
Still to be able to find that thread of gratitude and joy.
Yeah. There's a line from the poet Wendell Berry who says, be joyful though you have considered all the facts.
Right.
And I think that's what jazz does. It brings this sense of joy, and it has considered all the facts. And I like that. And may that be true for me in retirement.
Yeah, and practice living the resurrection.
Yes,
right?
That's right. That's right, however that manifests itself.
Yeah, so thank you.
Well,
more in a minute?
More in a moment. I just want to say, this is in some ways a formal last sermon on staff, or Jazz Vespers reflection, but I'm just so glad that I'm going to be here with the community. Mm-hmm. I'll actually be attending Jazz Vespers when we finally can do that in person, and the opportunity of doing reflections now and then feels wonderful. Yeah.
Well, great. And that helps me a lot personally, because you've been here for 16 years. I've been here for almost 8.
Woo.
And we've known each other and had a friendship for 21. And so if, like, you were taken off, like, this would not be easy to do.
No.
A lot more fun to do knowing that you're still going to have that kind of connection. And so.
And I'm looking forward to that.
Blessings to you.
A new stage in that journey here.
Yeah, wonderful. So I wish you love. I wish you love. This is the next piece that Jen will sing, and in so many ways, it's at the heart of what we're all about. Let's listen.
I wish you bluebirds in the spring to give your heart a song to sing, and then a kiss, but more than this, I wish you love. And in July, some lemonade to cool you in some leafy glade. I wish you health and more than wealth. I wish you love. Breaking heart, and I agree that you and I could never be. So with my best, my very best, I'll set you free. I wish you shelter from the storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, but most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. Snowflakes fall, I wish you love. wish you
Don't you just want to melt into that luscious voice of Jen's? That's beautiful.
Yeah. And such a song. Oh.
Yeah. I wish you love. So as someone who appreciates jazz, but also as a preacher, as a theologian, I wonder what that song evokes in you.
Well, Dan, as I've experienced Jazz Vespers, I've realized just how many great standards are, in fact, love songs. Either a heartbreak, we're falling apart, or I've just stumbled upon you and life is amazing and wonderful, how long will it last? And I want to celebrate that. I enjoy it myself, and the songs are gorgeous. But because I'm a preacher kind of guy, theologian is a nicer term perhaps, I always want to hear it differently as a metaphor for the relationship that exists between humans and the holy, the divine, God, the mystery. Right. And that in fact, what we're craving for and what we can experience is this love. And this song lifts up and says, although my heart is breaking, what I want to do is wish you love. And I feel like that's God wishing us love and hoping that we'll receive so much love that we'll start wishing it for other people. And it becomes a fill me up and then I spill over. And the way of love is what is celebrated in the Gospels over and over again. In fact, one of the epistles, one of the letters actually says, God is love. And I look to a great jazz player like John Coltrane, who says, you bet. And his name for God is A Love Supreme, which I think is one of the best names that I've heard. There's a poem that I know, and I've shared it with people before, but it bears repeating. It's by Raymond Carver, and it was offered in the last year or two of his life. It's his last published poem. He wrote it when he was struggling with terminal cancer. Mm-hmm. And in fact, the poem, short, is called Late Fragment. It's actually etched on his tombstone, which you can find if you go across the Strait of Juan de Fuca to Port Angeles. And he writes, and did you get what you wanted from this life? Even so. I did. And what was it that you wanted? To call myself beloved and to feel myself beloved on this earth. And I think that is one of the deepest and most essential human cravings. It's what we need when we're born into the world in a literal, physical, and touching kind of way. It's what we yearn for in our adolescent hormonal romance and lust mixing with love. It is in our best moments of sexuality and relationship. It spreads from perhaps a special one into family and then into friendship. And there are even these challenges of how can we love strangers? How can we love neighbors, some not known well to us? How can we even love our enemies? And the greatest thing you'll ever learn, says the song Nature Boy, is to love and to be loved in return. Mm-hmm. And so I want to lift that up from this song, I Wish You Love. And I would hope that that would be something all of us can hear, however we imagine or metaphorize the holy, that we are loved and that we can call ourselves beloved on this earth. Because I truly believe each and every one of us is, and all our relations as well. And that we will learn from that, that we also have the capacity to be, in a sense, holy or sanctified ourselves in as much as we're capable of love. Or we become a channel of that love, and it just flows through us. So when Jen is playing, I hear that. I think of past romances. I think of the holy and how I'm embraced. And I think of the call forward into learning more and more how to love. And whatever retirement is going to bring, there are going to be future lessons in learning how to love. I don't know how it will manifest itself, but that's the gift of this song. I wish you love. And it's perhaps what I would say to folks here in my sort of last formal Jazz Vespers reflection. I wish you love. It's not breaking up, but I'm departing and our paths will continue to cross. But oh my, do I wish you love. A holy love so that you feel beloved on this earth. Amen.
Amen. And Gary, I have to say, I'd be remiss if I didn't. But on behalf of everybody who has participated in Jazz Vespers over the course of the 16 years that you've been here, thank you for the love that you have shared with us week after week through your reflections and through your presence and through your welcoming of people. You have enfleshed the welcome that the Holy embraces each one of us with. You remind us that we are beloved. And that is at the heart of your ministry, and you hit that note right on every time you speak. And so thank you, my friend.
Oh, if these weren't pandemic times, I'd give you a huge hug. Huge hug. Yes.
Received.
Yes. Okay.
And so let's go to the next piece. Gary, we hope that whatever your retirement entails, and there'll be some meaningful engagement in that, no doubt, but may it be easy. May it also be easy. Go easy, my friend.
Oh, no problem. Okay. No problem.
Just me, yeah.
At a time like this, at a final service of sorts, it's tempting to try to find the most meaningful benediction and blessing that could possibly come from my mouth. But it is also the time to repeat over and over what I've said almost at the end of every Jazz Vespers service, really coming from my heart. Friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those we travel with. So be swift to love, and make haste to be kind. The hand of God to hold you, the grace of God enfold you, for the love that dreamed and formed you still surrounds you here today. The light of God be with you, beside, above, and within you. The light that shines to guide all of us home to the loving heart of the holy. Amen and amen.
Just when the fun is starting, comes the time for partying. But let's just be glad for what we've had and what's to come. There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Catch up some.